Great. Hi, how are you?
Hi. This is a sex adjacent story.
Sex adjacent. I love that.
So I met this guy on the Tinder.
Yeah.
And so I met him at this bar, walked in. Within 5 minutes, he has his tongue down my throat.
So like consensual or not so much?
It was semi.
Semi.
So we...
I don't think we're working with semi-consensual anymore.
Right. Okay. Well, it was pre-Me Too.
Okay. So it was cool.
It was acceptable. So we go back to my place, and we have sex. Sex adjacent.
Wow, this is not sex adjacent.
Well, that's...
This is penetrative sex, in fact.
Fair. So then
How was
we're
it?
Done. Fine.
Okay.
That's
what you want. That's what you want to hear. That was fine.
So he then goes into my bathroom and washes his dick in my sink.
I know the move.
Which, yeah.
So I'm familiar with the move.
I polled people and they say it's not normal. I polled several people.
I don't know. That's a great question.
Yeah.
Of the guys in the audience, how many here, by just cheer if you have ever washed your dick post-coitus in a sink? I don't know. This seems kind of normal. And we got some dirty dick motherfuckers in this piece.
That makes me feel better. So then he gets ready to go. It's like a quick thing. And he comes and he kisses me. Then he goes back to the bathroom and washes his mouth.
Oh my God.
So then at this point, I'm like, maybe he's not single. Like, that's...
Well, hold on. No questions from the peanut gallery. Somebody's... Wait, was your question, how did she know that he washed his mouth?
He left the door open.
That's pretty crazy. That's what a weird romantic. He's like, okay, babe, I gotta take off, but let me just get a kiss goodnight. Mwah. This has been really special. Oh, one more thing. You got your Sonicare. Do you have any Listerine? All you got is Scope. It's not powerful enough to wash away the memory. This is terrible.
So I clarified. I was like, did you just wash your dick and your mouth in my sink?
Right. And he's like, to be fair, I washed a little bit of my dick from my mouth. There was extra dick left over.
So I said, I just have to clarify, like, are you single? And he was like, oh, yeah.
Why did you, what about it?
Because it seemed like he was trying to, like, wash off my scent.
I gotcha.
You know, not smell like sex.
Okay,
so,
gotcha.
So he's like, yeah, I'm single. I really have a cleanliness thing.
Sure.
I was like, okay, bye. And so we left. And then he tried to friend me on Tinder again, or whatever you do. And he was like, I lost your number. Give me your number. And I was like, okay. So I gave him my number. He came over again. And
At this point, this is a fool me once situation. No, you know the old saying, wash your dick out of your own mouth once, shame on... Someone wash a dick, Tinder swipe me twice, shave on, don't call, stop. Why'd you fuck that guy? You know the old saying?
It hasn't gotten weird yet.
Okay. Oh, good. Oh. All right. She's like, bitch, I raised my hand at the end of the show for a reason.
Yeah, my name's Sally, too.
I know. What's the connection?
That my name's not Sally.
I didn't call you Sally, did I?
No, I know. I'm just saying for the recording, my name is Sally.
Oh, but say that it's not Sally? You've never been on a recording before, have you?
No.
She's like, my name is Sally, so don't say that my name is Sally on the recording. Okay? As a Sally, I don't want to be called Sally.
Do not call me Sally. So then we're in bed. He's on top of me.
Okay.
And he says, so I've been feeling really guilty.
He's inside of you?
No, he's on top, not inside. Still
so up. You're starting.
Outside.
Okay.
Sex adjacent.
Okay.
And he said, so I've been feeling really guilty. I was like, oh, okay. And he was like, so it's really not in my religion to have sex outside of marriage. Okay.
Well, what religion is it?
I'm going to
You're going to get to that?
Say.
Yeah, okay. Okay, Islam, go ahead. No, I mean, it's clear. She doesn't want to say, if it was a Jew, she'd be like, it was a big old Jew on top of me. But we're living in sensitive political times.
Post me too.
I gotcha. So whatever religion it was,
yeah.
Inshallah.
So I say, okay. And he said, but I've done some research.
Okay.
And there's this old tradition where we can get married and have sex and it can be like a temporary marriage.
I just converted to Islam.
And I said, well, I feel kind of uncomfortable with that because it.
Why? Why were you uncomfortable with that?
It just it felt disrespectful to this religion. I was like,
oh, it felt disrespectful to the religion?
I don't know. I didn't feel...
I would have thought that it was a more Sally-based disrespect you were worried about.
No, that ship sailed.
Okay.
So...
I love you.
So
I want to temporarily marry you.
So I was like, well, you know, I just want you to know that, like, I don't believe in this, and, like... if you're okay with that, then cool, that's fine. Because he said it was the only way we could have sex. And he was literally on top of me.
Right.
So we got married.
Oh my God. How? What was the ceremony?
It was really quick.
Yeah, obviously.
I think he put the sheet over my head.
He pulled the sheet over your head?
He said something, I said something. And...
you know, earlier when you said the self-respect ship had sailed, I was like, Sally, don't talk about you like that. And now I'm kind of like, oh, okay, I feel you.
I think it's like body positive, sex positive.
You are body positive and
yeah.
sex positive. Yeah, no, no doubt. But the part where marrying into a marriage of convenience for a 15-second sexual encounter and then immediately getting a divorce, that's the part that I'm like, scratchy, scratchy.
Yeah. Okay.
So he did it. And what did he say something? Did he incant?
Yeah, there was like a little...
there was an incantation?
Yeah.
Whoa. And did you have to say anything?
I did.
What'd you say?
I don't know. It was like really short.
So you answered.
It was like I give myself to you for 30 days.
Whoa.
That was the period. We had to set a period of time.
And it was
30
days. Why 30 days? Why not 30 seconds?
I don't know.
So then you, then what?
Well,
then
he, do you want to know? I had.
I want to know everything.
My dowry.
Oh, you had to get a dowry? She's like, I don't want to say what religion, but there was a dowry. What was your dowry? Wait, is that what you received? You had to pay him?
Well, I don't know. Maybe it's not a dowry.
You had to give him something or he gave you something?
He gave me... well, he was meant to give me a meal.
A meal. This motherfucker is straight up making shit up as he goes along. This is a crowd work album, and I don't respect this guy as a man, but as a practitioner of comedic improvisational arts, I gotta tip my hat to this dude. He's like, and I give you a meal and a sheet over your head, and we're married. Okay.
Yeah. So then we had sex, and it was fine, and he left.
It wasn't the wedding night you'd always dreamed of.
Second time's the charm.
Right.
Yeah, and then a couple days later, he messaged me on Tinder and said, I lost your phone number.
I'm sure he's made some wife of his very
and
happy.
And I did not respond.
Well, good for you. The ship has sailed back in. How about a round of applause?